Now would you join me putting your hands together and thanking God for this anointed man as he leads us tonight. Help me welcome Paul Wilbur.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Baruch haba b'shem Adonai. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
You are welcome in this place. Be enthroned upon our praises. May our worship rise like incense as we magnify the sun. Mighty God of Israel, you're the Lamb upon the throne. All blessing and honor to our God forevermore. Even so, even so. Yeshua, come. All creation cries for the returning of our King. Come and take your place on your throne, Jerusalem.
Jerusalem.
take your place on your throne, Jerusalem.
And Elijah said to the people, "Why do you waver between two opinions? If the Lord is God, then serve him. But if the Baals are God, then serve them. But make up your mind. And 1 Kings 18 records a very sad line. The people answered him not a word. And so Elijah said, this is what we're going to do. You hundreds of prophets of the Baals, you set up your altar, present your offering, but put no fire under it. I'll do the same. And the God who answers by fire, let him be God." And so all day long, from morning until night, they set up their altar, they prepared the offering. They sang and danced and they shouted. They cut themselves with stones and they bled their blood into the earth. But still no fire from heaven. And so about the time of the third offering, Elijah, the prophet of God, he took 12 stones and he rebuilt the altar. He placed wood on it, he prepared the offering, and laid it on top of the wood. Then he called for a great amount of water to be poured upon the offering. And a second time, and a third time, until the water soaked the offering, the wood, the stones, and filled a great ditch that surrounded the altar of the Lord. And then he lifted up his hands toward heaven. And he said these words, "God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known today that you alone are God in all the land." And fire fell from heaven. And it consumed the offering, and it consumed the wood and the stones, and it licked up the great amount of water that had filled the ditch. And the people fell on their faces, and they declared, "The Lord, he is God. The Lord, he is God." Stand with me tonight, and let's declare it together. The Lord, he is God. The Lord, he is God.
Holy fire, you are the holy one. Come on, give the Lord a good shout of praise.
You alone are God every day. I'm it's a sound of victory. For the power of his voice will rout the enemy. There's no weapon that can defeat us here. We will triumph on every side. More than conquerors through the might of Adonai. Oh, the walls may stand before us. Emerson on every side.
God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob, Elohim Adonai, God who answers by fire, glorify your Son, Jesus Christ, the true Messiah. Breathe on us, send us out in the spirit of Elijah. Who answers by fire. Jesus Christ, the true Messiah. Breathe on us, send us out in the spirit of Elijah. Oh, hey, worship me, God. Worship me, Lord. Holy worship me, God. We lift you up, we lift you up, we lift you up.
To the Lord, all you that have breath, sing his praise, for he alone is worthy to be praised. All you stars in your courses, come bring your praises to me. from the rising of the sun till the end of every day, I will say Hallelujah, Adonai. And all the nations of the earth, with all the angels and the saints, sing praise, Adonai. From the rising of the sun till the end of every day, praise Adonai. And all the nations of the earth, with all the angels and the saints, sing praise Adonai. Everything that now has breath, if you are now awake, if you hear the word of God, come and stir your heart with mine. Together with the angels and the saints, we bow before your throne to declare holy, holy, kadosh, kadosh. There is none like you, O Lord.
God of Israel. Elders bow in worship as the angel voices swell. Fragrant clouds of incense swirl around your throne of grace. Lord, we bow in worship at the brilliance of your face. We cry,
oh,
receive our praise. Holy, 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 you're the Son of God, and you are awesome, God of power, Lord.
Lord of glory. Fill this place awesome. My soul finds rest in God alone. My peace depends on Him. And in that place of quiet rest, He fills me from within. Holy oil, the Spirit of Adonai. Then He takes me by His hand, comforts me with His love, comforts me. Oh. my soul. Take your rest and find your peace in Him. The holy presence of the Lord will fill you from within. Oh, pour on me your holy Spirit of Adonai. Fill my cup, I lift it up until I overflow. Oh, pour on me your holy Spirit of the living God. Fill my cup, Lord, I lift it up until I
Lord, fill each cup in this house. In your presence is fullness of joy. Bind up the brokenhearted, set at liberty those who are bound. Bring healing to the broken in body. Restore. The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is upon me because the Lord has anointed me to speak good news to the poor. He sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, open prison doors, to pour out the oil of gladness, and to distribute garments of praise, that those who believe would be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, for the display of His splendor. We declare sickness has no place in this house. Division, dissension, you must go now. Broken hearts, be mended by the loving embrace of the lover of your soul. Cancer, go now in Yeshua's name. Blind eyes, open. Deaf ears, be unstopped. Tumors, go in Jesus' name. Yeshua said, come to do the will of Him who sent me, and I only do what I see my Father do. And then He said to us, go in my name, heal the sick, raise the dead, cast out the kingdom of darkness. Lord, we declare in this place tonight, we are disciples. We are awake. We are hearers and doers. That you would be glorified, and that the name above every name will be seen and heard and honored. Glorify your name in all the earth.
The springtime. the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And though these are days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sword, still we are the voice in the desert, crying, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, it's a year of jubilee. Now does Zion's hill, salvation comes. And these are the days of Ezekiel, those dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding a temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest, the fields are widening the world. And we are your laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. Trumpet call, so lift your voice, it's a year of jubilee. Now that Zion's here, salvation comes. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice, it's a year of jubilee. Now that Zion's here, salvation.
Oh,
mystery behind the veil. Lord over heaven and earth, God of Israel, come with your wisdom and power, clothe in your honor and strength. Lord, hear the cry of our hearts, come, O conquering King, come Lord and every.
Paul's been a part of our company really for many, many years, and part of some of the biggest events we've done. And I think it's because it's all tied around Yeshua, our Messiah. And it's like, this is something that's transcultural, it's transdenominational. I mean, you go anywhere in the world, and people are praying for Jerusalem, and they're praying for it.
It's an awesome time. We're really expecting God to show up, and I think Paul's prayer, my prayer certainly, is that God would bring new revelation, that he would show up in power and his glory that we've never seen before in a way that we haven't experienced, and it's going to be a great evening.
Pioneered messianic worship in a really amazing way, and I think that the Lord is starting to sort of use him and turn the focus, and you know, he's now going from a leader to a father.
Paul is at a very unique place, and is a, you know, as one of our key artists, you know, I want to help build a platform under what God has called Paul to do.
You are Lord over all the earth. You are Lord over all the earth.
Come on and declare it. You are Lord.
Oh, man. Since 98, I've lived in just north of Colorado Springs with my family, and did a Christmas album last year. That was the newest thing I've done. Just been singing, traveling, doing some writing, working with different artists, and just involved in music like I have been since I was 13.
I'm so anticipating what he's going to do tonight. In fact, I've already in rehearsals had to stop because the presence of the Lord was so real and so heavy that I couldn't sing. So I think that will be magnified many times tonight, not only by those of us in this troupe, but those who are coming tonight. We're going to see some miraculous things from the Lord.
Has such a strong vision for the nations, and it's just a joy to kind of be part of somebody that thinks globally and takes worship and the messianic message of Yeshua into the earth, and what it releases in the churches and to people around the world has been so powerful.
Experienced some Fall Wilbur concerts in the past, but what was really special for me was the performance of Adonai. Was really spectacular. I've never heard anything like it before. Probably will never hear anything since. And it's always really, really special to see Paul and, you know, his entourage that he brings with him. It's just really, it kind of brings you back to what's real with God, and you know what worship is really, you know, supposed to be like. It's excellent.
So the watchman is awake, the watchman is alert, and the watchman sounds the alarm.
The calling of the watchman is to hear what God is saying and sound an alarm, give a word of warning to the society, to the body, so that we can be awakened, so that we can turn to God. And if we hear the voice of the watchman, we will live and be blessed.